Hello, my name is Marek Polet, and I would like to invite you to the next part of the Grenton Academy, where I will tell you about the Grenton Gate Modbus integration module. Modbus is an integration protocol that was developed in the late 70s by Modicon and has been recognized as the engineering standard in the automation industry. Modbus is an open protocol that uses the principle of master-slave data exchange. Today, it is used by many manufacturers of both industrial automation devices and devices which we use every day in our homes. You can find the Modbus protocol in devices such as heat pumps, recuperation, air conditioning, or solid fuel boilers. But you can also find it in weather stations, energy meters, or photovoltaic inverters. In order to be able to connect the previously mentioned devices to the system, your system must have a Gate Modbus module. One Gate Modbus module allows you to connect 8 different devices on one bus, which can work at different speeds. The maximum length of the Modbus bus, because it is a separate bus than the TF bus bus, can be 300 meters long, and on one such device you can save up to 400 different virtual objects, which means that one such module will handle up to 400 registers. Registers, in other words, various parameters read from devices. The Gate Modbus module is a CLU class device, and to connect it to the system, we do not use the system bus, but we use the internet layer. This means that the module simply has to be in the same network as the CLU module and the rest of our system. As I said before, one Gate Modbus module will allow us to connect, in other words, handle 8 different devices on one bus. If we would like to connect more than 8 Modbus devices to our system, we can use more Gate Modbus modules and connect them all in the same way. In other words, connect all of them to the same Ethernet network in which the rest of our system is located. The module communicates with the system via the Ethernet port, but as you can see, we also have TF bus connectors. These connectors are not used to communicate with other elements of the system, but only to be installed on the same rail with other modules. So if you connect TF bus tapes from neighboring modules here, this communication will simply be passed on. The module itself will not be involved in this communication. The module must be connected to the power supply. We can do it with the use of TF bus connectors and power it from the system bus side, but also from the second side. We have 2 connectors here, GND and 24VDC. You can also power this module with these connectors. I would like to point out only that the powering supply the module from the connector side, 24VDC GND, will not cause a bus strength at its connection point. Communication in the Modbus protocol is carried out using the RS485 physical layer, and this means that the device will be connected using 2 pairs of wires. The first pair will be responsible for data transmission, and you can now see them here on the diagram marked with the letters A and B. The second pair is responsible for powering the devices. The Gate Modbus module is a master class device, and the receivers or slave devices are connected to it by using a serial bus, the maximum length of which should not exceed 300 meters. Remember to use a constant wave impedance cable as a transmission cable. It can be, for example, UTP or Grenton TF bus smartphone cable. Also remember to use termination at the ends of the bus in the module itself. This termination is already used here, while for the last device, a 120 ohm resistor should be installed. I will show you now what the configuration of the Gate Modbus module in the Grenton system looks like. I've already connected the Gate Modbus module to my system. This is the module which you can see here, and the bus which we connected it to. At the second end, we have connected the heat pump controller. Now look what the configuration of this driver looks like. After the CLU discovery function has been executed in our project, a new module appeared in the object manager, described as CLU and serial number. And this is the Gate module we have just added to the system. After opening the properties of this object, you can see practically the same set of features, methods, and events as for CLU modules, and the configuration of the device connected to the bus takes place using virtual objects. So we select the Gate Modbus module, we choose a new virtual object, We add this object, and I would like to read the current temperature from my heat pump, served from the lower source. We will label the new object as the red temperature. And now we see what the module configuration issue looks like. Let's go straight to the embedded features, because this is how we should start configuring this module. The first value that should be set is the value of the address of the device connected to our system. You can read what this address is in the device documentation, and many devices also allow you to dynamically change this address. My device has the address number 1. Then we go to the configuration of the register itself. So we will jump for a moment to the instructions of my device and look. This is the table with the register parameters. The first register I would like to give it has the address 1018 and has the R access type, which is read-only, and is a 32-bit float register. So we go back to my configuration. The type of access is set to read, because the device allows only and exclusively to read the value from this register and enter the register access in accordance with the table, in other words, 1018. The next parameter to be set is the baud rate. I know from the manual that my device communicates at 9600 speeds and the types of the read values. And, as you could see before, it will be a 32-bit float type. So, we change the value to float and bit count to 32. You can see bit position here. This is the bit value from which we will start reading and bit count, in other words, to which we will count. And both of these parameters can be found in the manual of the connected device. The next two parameters inform us about how often we will want to read the values from our device and after what time we expect a response. In my case, we will read the values every second. And if the answer does not occur within 100 milliseconds, the system will report an error. The next parameter is divisor. Because the Modbus register can return us a value without taking into account the decimal point, for example, if we want to read the temperature, we can read the value 200. And in this case, by setting the divisor value to 10, we will be able to divide ourselves to the actual value, which we will later present in the system. The endianness feature determines the order of the red bits, and in my case, I also know that from the documentation of the connected devices, it will be swap bytes and words. Registry type. We should also get to know the manual of the connected device, and I know that in the case of my device, it will be holding registers. The value, set at the initial value, you can now declare yourself here. We are left with two important features, the stop bits and parity bit, and these are also the values which must be set in accordance with the instructions attached to the device. In my case, it will be stop bits equal 1. Now you can see what each of these values means. So in case of 1, we have 1.5 stop bits and no parity bit. These two parameters are used to secure the correctness of the transmission. And now, after all parameters have been set correctly, we send the configuration to the gate module, and in a moment, we will be able to see if the communication is working properly. Now, let's see if I have correctly configured our object. Let's move on to the embedded features. And now you see, I am able to read the value on my heat pump, which today is 21.38 degrees. This type of register allows us to read the parameters only and exclusively. In other words, what parameters the device has at the moment, we can download to the system, and on the basis of this value, we can build logic in the system. The devices also have parameters that we can control. In other words, if we wanted to use the Grenton system to set the temperature, change the operating mode, this is what we use the other types of registry for. So, now we will give ourselves another registry. My heat pump allows you to control the water temperature in the domestic hot water tank. So at this point, I will create an object which will allow me to control this temperature. We will call it the DHW temperature. And the configuration is very similar to the previous one. So we also start with assigning the device address. It will be 1. Let's check what type of registry it is. See, this is the type RW, so read and write. Then, the address of that register. It will be 1026. The baud rate is the same as before, so 9600, and the value type, float. Also remember that in this case we have to change the bit count trait to 32 bits and endianness to swap bytes and words. Then, after sending the configuration, we will be able to control the temperature in the domestic hot water tank. In the embedded features, we can check where the current value is set on my heat pump for the domestic water temperature. And using the set value method, we can now change this temperature freely. And now you can see, after refreshing, the value changed to match what I set. After adding registers to the system as virtual objects to create any type of logic. We will now create a simple script on the CLU module, with the help of which we will regulate the temperature in the water reservoir. We'll call it the DHW temperature. We will add the first condition to determine what time we want to change the temperature. In this situation, I would like that after 6 p.m. the temperature of the water in my reservoir will be raised as we are getting ready for our evening bath. So, we issue a condition and then actions. And now see the configuration of these objects. It looks exactly the same as in all other systems. In other words, I choose the DHW temperature parameter, choose the set value method, and enter the value 50 degrees here. And now, the script prepared and opened in this way can be connected to the calendar rule or the module and the event scheduler. And at 6 p.m., the water in my tank will be heated to the set temperature. And this is exactly how you can configure and use the registers read from devices connected to the Modbus bus in the entire system. And similarly, to creating logic. We will use these objects in the same way when creating an application for mobile devices to my interface. I have already added buttons here, with which I will be able to change the temperature and water in the hot utility water tank. And now, I will show you how to read the value from the heat pump. For this purpose, we add a value type widget. And then, into the value field, we add the value feature of our virtual object. Additionally, because I know that we will read the temperature, we can change the unit to degrees. And after sending this interface, you will be able to control the heat pump from your smartphone. Thank you for your attention, and feel warmly invited to the next part of Grenton Academy. See you next time!